right there from the House of Humperdinck, the Canadian Lumberjack, the TV champ, big, tough, rough, the Lumberjack, Joe LeDuc. What a match this is going to be. And his opponent across the ring, none other than Rick Steamboat. And boy, the crowd already with that chant, Steamboat, Steamboat, Steamboat. LeDuc goes right out of the ring. Humperdinck is really upset by it all. Look at the eyes on the wild Lumberjack. A mountain of a man. I tell you, just looking at him will frighten you, and he's every bit as mean and rough and tough as he looks. And against one of the most outstanding young men in professional wrestling, a young man who certainly has a great potential ahead of him, Rick Steamboat, a Hawaiian. As LeDuc was going to take his head off of that right, Steamboat ducked right under it, out of the corner with a hip toss, drop kick. Well, when he gets to his feet, another drop kick, and again, LeDuc's going to go out of the ring. Rick Steamboat right now in the ring against one member of the House of Humperdinck, and of course, there are several members of that House of Humperdinck that Rick Steamboat would like to catch in the ring, including Leroy Brown and Greg Valentine. Bad, bad Leroy and Valentine, two more from the House of Humperdinck that Steamboat is just itching to get in that ring. This is a main event match anywhere in the world, fans. The TV champ, Joe LeDuc, against Rick Steamboat. You're watching it right here on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. LeDuc had the headlock. Boy, he came with a big, hard, big right fist. Steamboat down on one knee and off of the rope. Boy, he wound up again with that right. It almost cut him a flip. Stood him on his head as he got the full force of that right hand. And LeDuc quickly on the attack. Measures him again for the big right hand. As big and strong as this guy is, he can throw a powerful punch. He can turn your lights out any number of ways, can Joe LeDuc. It makes him all the more dangerous too, fans, having someone like Sir Oliver Humperdinck in his corner. LeDuc, though, we had talked about Steamboat, who had a score to settle with Leroy Brown, goes down again as LeDuc comes off of the rope. That time picks him up. Hard power slam now by Steamboat. And that Steamboat also would like to meet Greg Valentine. There's one man still very much. Another tremendous power slam. Hot on the trail now of LeDuc, and of course that's Jimmy Valiant. The Boogeyman, the Wild Man, the Backbreaker. Steamboat has him covered, only a count of two, and LeDuc just throws him halfway across the ring. Knee to the back of the kid. He has got the pressure on the neck. The neck and the back. Steamboat now still applying that pressure out near the center of the ring. Boy, Humperdinck's about to go eight. Fans, in the next match, you're going to see another outstanding young man, Mike Rotundo, the tremendous young man out of Syracuse University, against one of the members of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Gene Anderson. Here is Steamboat up riding his back. Out of the corner, had him rolled up. Only a count of one, and Steamboat flew into the ropes. LeDuc slammed him into the corner, and Steamboat is really hurt. He went full force right into one of the turnbuckles. Mike Rotundo against Gene Anderson, that matchup next. Then you're going to see the world tag team champions, Sergeant Slaughter and Don Kernodle. Hard chop from Steamboat as LeDuc came into the corner after him. And Steamboat now is backing him up. Up again for the slam, and he couldn't hold him. Two, almost for the count of three. Hard now to the turnbuckle. LeDuc will just measure you for that right hand. Again, the crowd now picking up the chance. Steamboat, Steamboat. LeDuc got him hanging right in the air by his throat. Slams him to the mat. Boy, we'll just give you some idea of the tremendous strength of this big Canadian. Steamboat just freaks that leg out from under him. Came with a chop. Again, a trade chop. And here's LeDuc coming back with one. Steamboat back to almost into the corner, and LeDuc with a hard chop, and out he comes, and down goes LeDuc. Only a count of one. LeDuc diving in after Steamboat. He wants him right now any way he can get him. Went to the hair. He's going to maul him. He's going to hurt him anyway. What a match, fans. Right here on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, this match, Rick Steamboat, the TV champ, Joe LeDuc. A mountain of a man, the wild man in the ring, LeDuc. A handful of hair. They're going to just drag him back to the ropes. Steamboat could be in bad trouble right here, draped across the rope. Right behind him outside of the ring. And Steamboat went to the eyes. Pawing at the eyes of the Duke who came after him on the rope. Across the ring, hard now to the turnbuckle. Again now to the turnbuckle. Again across the ring, and right now Steamboat has got it going his way. He was going to bulldog him, and LeDuc slams him into the turnbuckle. Off and down. And a count of two. He almost had LeDuc for the three. Steamboat now trying to turn him over, and LeDuc fighting it. Swings against Swings, and here comes Dory Funk Jr. and gets Steamboat from behind. As Funk comes charging into the ring, he's got Steamboat. Referee Stu Schwartz says ring the bell, and Funk now holding Steamboat for LeDuc. And LeDuc landing those tremendous right hands. Here comes Jay Youngblood, and Dory Funk goes over to meet Youngblood as he starts in the ring. Humperdinck being held by the referee as LeDuc continues to pound away now at Steamboat. Here's Youngblood. There goes LeDuc out of the ring, and now Funk is caught there. And he goes down as Steamboat and Youngblood both are after Dory Funk, and Funk finally.